morning. Welcome to this all-age service on Mothering Sunday. It's lovely to see you all here today, and you should all have a brick, which you'll find out what happens later on in the service. And so we begin our time of worship. Everything is on the screens, but you should have a notice sheet that you can take home, and you can respond to things on there and use it in your time of prayer. So we look to the screens for our order of service, and we begin by saying, "Praise God who loves us, praise God who cares." And we're going to sing the hymn, "Fathers and Mothers," and you will know the tune, hopefully. Come on, Patrick, come and help light this candle. This is Patrick. I don't need your brick at the moment. Whoops. Right, I want you to hold that still. Oh, it's going to go out. Don't have much luck with candles. So we're lighting this candle because the candle represents, there we go, light in the darkness. It shines in the darkness. Right, you can go and sit down now, sweet. Oh, take your brick. So we light this candle to remind us that the love of God is like a light in our darkness. Blessed be God forever. We praise you, our God, for all mothers who have loved and laughed and labored as they cared for their children. Blessed be God forever. We praise you, our God, for all mothers who have wept in sorrow and joy for their children. Blessed be God forever. We praise you, our God, for Jesus, born of a woman and nurtured in her love. And for Mary, a reminder of patient waiting love. Blessed be God forever. So let us call to mind our sin, our failure to value the love of others, and our failure to love as Christ has loved us. So just a moment of silence. Your love gives us life from the moment of conception, yet we fail to live as your children. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You call us to do good, we seek our own good. Christ, have mercy. You hear us when we cry for help. We ignore the cries of others. Lord, have mercy. May the Father of all mercies cleanse us from our sins and restore us in his image, to the praise and glory of his name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And the collect for Mothering Sunday. God of love, passionate and strong, tender and careful, watch over us and hold us all the days of our life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Praise God who loves us. Praise God who cares. So we stand and sing our second hymn, The King is Among Us. For our Bible readings, and apologies, they're not the same ones that are on the new sheet.
Good morning. So our first reading is from the Old Testament, from the book of Exodus, chapter 2, verses 1 to 10, all about the birth of Moses. Now, a man of the tribe of Levi married a Levite woman, and she became pregnant and gave birth to a son. When she saw that he was a fine child, she hid him for 3 months. But when she could hide him no longer, she got a papyrus basket for him and coated it with tar and pitch. Then she placed the child in it and put it among the reeds along the bank of the Nile. His sister stood at a distance to see what would happen to him. Then Pharaoh's daughter went down to the Nile to bathe, and her attendants were walking along the riverbank. She saw the basket among the reeds and sent her female slave to get it. She opened it and saw the baby. He was crying, and she felt sorry for him. "This is one of the Hebrew babies," she said. Then his sister asked Pharaoh's daughter, "Shall I go and get one of the Hebrew women to nurse the baby for you?" "Yes, go," she answered. So the girl went and got the baby's mother. Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Take this baby and nurse him for me, and I will pay you." So the woman took the baby and nursed him. When the child grew older, she took him to Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son. She named him Moses, saying, "I drew him out of the water." So now we move on to the New Testament, to the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, verses 33 to 35. The child's father and mother marveled at what was said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "This child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thoughts of many hearts will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too."
Thanks be to God. For just a moment of prayer, may the words of my mouth and the thoughts of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Mothering Sunday. Mothering Sunday can be difficult for some. I don't know about you, but I get emails coming up to Mothering Sunday asking if I want to opt out, but obviously I don't, but I am aware that it can be difficult for some. And also families can be very diverse these days. Yes, mum and dad are traditional family, but also single parents, families with two mums, families with two dads, bringing up children, working hard for their families, and they all need support. What I just want to touch on briefly is that some of the liturgy that I've used today has been taken from the Mothers Union website. Now, we don't hear about Mothers Union much these days. It was very, very active when I was growing up, certainly. And I know there are groups on the island, but not as active as it used to be. Mothers Union is actually very, very much alive, especially in Africa. All over the world, they're still doing some amazing, amazing work. They're supporting communities, fighting for change. And their vision, which I think we should take on board, our vision is a world where everyone prospers. We actively pursue this vision through prayer and action, helping to build confident people and resilient communities. Our movement seeks to bring about justice, challenge prejudice, and advocate change. So I think that's a good vision to take on board. Anyway, when I was growing up in Blackburn, Lancashire, that Mothers Union was very, very strong at that time. And I had two aunties, elderly aunties. Two aunties who'd never married due to the war and the men going off to fight and not coming back. And they were very tiny, really tiny, and they wore size 2 shoes. I don't think any female wears size 2 shoes these days. But they were very, very active in the Mothers Union. I did ask my mother, because I couldn't understand it at some point, why they were in the Mothers Union when they, what I could see, they weren't mothers. So I did ask my mother one day, why are they in the Mothers Union when they don't have their own children? And the answer is, but they are mothers to many. They help and support many, many families through the Mothers Union. And I also came to realise that they were helping bringing up me and my sister. So in a way, they were mothers to us as well. And for me, they were a safe place that I can go and sit in their cosy kitchen by the fire. So they were mothers in a different sort of way. As I've touched on, Mothering Sunday can be difficult for some, for those who have not been able to have children, perhaps. For those who've had a child die. For those who've had a baby die. Perhaps for those who are estranged from their children, it can be very difficult, and I always think that we ought to acknowledge this and also hold these people in prayers. But they can be mothers in a different sort of way. I'm really fortunate because I enjoy Mothering Sunday today, and then later on in the year, I have American Mother's Day as well, so I get it twice. But I'm very, very fortunate. And yes, we celebrate mothers, and I don't want to take anything away from that in what I'm going to do next, but actually, it does take a community. It takes a community to raise a child, as I put in the Gurnard News. Mothers are really special, but they can't do it without the support of everybody else. So you've all got some building blocks, because I want to look at different aspects in our community and put it all together, if it works, that is. You should all have a brick. So I want to build community. Okay. So I do have some help in the form of my grandsons, Patrick and Joel, and any other child at heart that wants to help as well. Because we can all be children at heart. So Patrick's got a brick and Joel's got a brick. So you just leave that with me a minute. So I've got a list somewhere of bricks because we're going to build a tower. So has anybody got any bricks with community events on? Yeah, two over there, some over there. Can you go and get them, Patrick or Joel? Oh. Joel, Patrick, look at people who were holding their hands up. Joel, there's some at the back. Thank you. So, right, I want you two to put... There's one over there. Yeah? So has anybody got a brick with a C on it? Yeah, right, go and collect all the bricks with C's on, please. Can you see the people holding it? Oh, bring them up. Give them to the boys and bring them. Thank you. Very good. Thank you. Right, I want you to put these bricks with C on onto here and start building a tower, okay? Make sure they've got a C on it. That's got church on it. Anybody else that wants to help can? Any with a C? We must have more. It's got to have a C on it, yeah? That's brilliant. Is that all with C? See, thank you. We've got to have it so that we're building a tower that's strong. No, that's not got. Let's have a look. That's not got. That's not got a seal. That's antis on there. It has to have a C on it. All those have got C's on, have they? Okay. So we're building it, like, in a square. Sorry about this. Has that got a C? Oh, it has, yeah. Okay, so we've got to find... Oh, dear. There we go. I think, or a civil engineer. Right, we're just going to go if that's got church. Right, go and find any that have got schools on. School, that's just right for you. Church. Baby groups. See. Well, we're getting there, aren't we, boys? Right, we're looking at community groups now, like Scouts and Brownies and Guides, or, yeah, Scouts, Cubs, Brownies, Guides, whatever. community groups. Okay. No, that goes further up. Church goes further up. Do you want to stay and help build this tower? What's that one? That is guides. Okay. That is scouts. So we've got to get these all fitted in.
Oh.
Okay, right, we'll sit, put that on there. This is going to work, but it's not going to be perfect. Anyway. Good.
There we are.
Right, are you building, boys? Rainbows, cubs. We want it all to fit together, so... Keep going, keep building. That's right there. Put that there. Yeah, it does. Anyway, we're getting there. It seemed like a good time. Keep building, boys and girls. Right, where have we gone up to? Right, has anybody got one with church on? I think we've got one here. Church. Lots of churches, good. It's not going to. So we should have some. We should have four with godparent on. Right, go and find the ones with godparent on. Okay. Godparents are very, very important in bringing up children. They're the ones that pray for their godchildren. Oh, okay. Just a minute. We need to stabilise this a little bit, I think. There. There's one. Aunties and uncles? Is anybody an auntie and uncle? There you go. Patrick, Joel, go and get that. Well, it's got a bit of design flow. I think the point is, the point I'm trying to make is it takes a whole community and it takes all these things to support mums and dads. Dads will have their day later on in the year. Uncles. Children. Right, children. It's not quite as I planned it, but anyway, never mind. Children. Child. Oh, what have we got there? Thank you. Another child. Well done. granddads, nans, grandmas. Right, off you go. Joel? Oh, sorry. Nan. Thank you. Grandma. Do you have a grandma, Patrick and Joel?
Yeah.
No? Patrick says he hasn't got a grandma. Now, there should be just two left. Is that right? A mum and a dad. Oh. That was a community group. Dad and a mum. There we go, let's give you a clap. Right, you can go and sit down, boys. Well done. It's not quite how I designed it originally, but I just wanted to sort of show some of the different aspects in community that help support families, mums, dads, when bringing up children. And it's not just down to mum and dad, it's down to all of us. And especially in our churches, it's down to us to pray for our families, for the children in our community. A community that works together is stronger for caring for each other and supporting and bringing up children and keeping them safe. In that first reading, the Levite woman became pregnant and she gave birth. And when the child was 3 months old, she couldn't hide it for any longer. So she took, in a way, that big decision to give him up. And how must it have been for her to put him in a basket and send him down the Nile, down the river? That must have been terrible for her, but community picked the baby out, the Pharaoh's slave picked the baby out, and Moses was allowed to grow up and obviously go on to lead a people. Mary, the mother of Jesus, she had to give Jesus up to do God's will. Mothers, at some point, have to put their children in the hands of others, especially when going to school, brownies, cubs, when they get older, squirrels. Joel was a squirrel. Beavers, scouts, whatever. Different groups, music groups, whatever. They put their children in the hands of other people, trusting that they will care for them. It's tough love being a mother, but better with the backing of a strong community, and each person has a part to play in their lives. When I was working at the hospital, okay, some of the people had what they called a work mummy. So even when you're older, you can have a mummy, a special person that you go to, just to be a listening ear. Again, I couldn't have done without that. A church family to support and celebrate and pray for mothers. And so today we do celebrate and we do give thanks. And dads, you will get your day later in the year. And we give thanks for all people in our community that help and love and support us and are our sort of surrogate mothers. Amen. So I think we're going to sing again. We're going to sing the hymn, "Make Me a Channel of Your Peace." Thank you. we remain standing as we affirm our faith. So let us declare our faith in God. We believe in God the Father, for whom every family in heaven and earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So please be seated for our time of prayer.
Loving God, you have given us the right to be called children of God. Help us to show your love in our homes, that they may be places of love, security, and truth. God of love, hear our prayer. Loving God, Jesus, your Son, was born into the family of Mary and Joseph. Bless all parents and all who care for children. Strengthen those families living under stress. And may your love be known where no human love is found. Go, God of love, hear our prayers. Loving God, we thank you for the family of the church. We pray that all may find in her their true home, that the lonely, the marginalized, the rejected may be welcomed and loved in the name of Jesus. God of love. Loving God, as we see the brokenness of our world, we pray for healing among the nations, for food where there is hunger, for freedom where there is oppression, for joy where there is pain. That your love may be bring peace to all your children. God of love, hear our prayer. As God's children and heirs with Christ, we cry in the Spirit, Abba Father, as we say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power and the glory.
Please stand. Through the prophet Isaiah, God says, as a mother comforts her child, so will I comfort you. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. For the care of mothers, thanks be to God. For their patience when tested, thanks be to God. For their love when tired, for their hope when despairing, for the service, for their service without limits. Let these flowers, Lord, bless these flowers that they may be a sign of your unending love and care for us. Amen. I don't know what you usually do. Do you give them out or do people come up and receive? Okay. Okay, right. Any children want to come and help? Yes, Claire, you're a child at heart. Right, come on. Okay. You could be a child. Okay, so we're going to give them out to mums first and then anybody else. So do you want to come up and receive a posy? Or are we going to go and give them out?
Yes.
Right, okay, we're going to go and give them out. Right, for all the ladies, Patrick. Yeah. For all the ladies, and then the men can have them. Yes. Give the sailing club to go on. Flowers are absolutely beautiful, so I just want to say thank you to all the ladies who came yesterday and made up the little bouquets of flowers. And also, if there's any men that want to take some flowers, I think there's enough left to take home for their mother as well, if they still have one. I think my son's there. He could give me one. Thank you. Thank you. Yes, thank you. Thank you. Oh, hint, hint. Thank you, son. Still some left. Anybody else without?
Go on, have you got one? Do you want another one? Yes, go on.
There you go.
You can give it to Rachel.
Thank you, Patrick. There's still two left if anybody wants to take one at the end. So thank you, God, for the love of mothers. Thank you, God, for their care and concern. Thank you, God, for the joys they have shared with us. Thank you, God, for the pains they have borne us. Thank you, God, for all they give us. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And so we stand and sing our final hymn, Brother, Sister, Let Me Serve You. May God, who gave birth to all creation, bless us. May God, who became incarnate by an earthly mother, bless us. May God, who broods as a mother over her children, bless us. May Almighty God bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ.